At the end of her tether, Brittany makes one last appointment with Dr. Daniel Jala.
Her symptoms were compatible with a diagnosis of chronic Lyme disease. But I began to suspect there might be something else going on in addition to Lyme disease.
Dr. Jala orders a series of blood tests to confirm his hunch. 1 month later, Brittany and Patty receive the results.
Brittany's test results, it showed that not only did she have persistent Lyme disease, but also confirmed that she was suffering also from babesiosis.
I had never heard of babesiosis before in my life. I was completely shocked.
Babesiosis is caused by a protozoan parasite called Babesia microti. When a person's infected, the parasite targets red blood cells, which transport oxygen throughout the body, and that can cause numerous problems for the host.
Inside Brittany's bloodstream, the Babesia parasites continue to invade red blood cells, where they feed and reproduce. Eventually, the parasites destroy the red blood cells, flooding the body with their offspring. As the Babesia parasites wipe out the cells, Brittany's oxygen levels decrease, resulting in extreme fatigue.
It was very frightening and scary to know that I've had a parasite living in my body for the past 8 years and I didn't even know it.
In many cases, those infected don't experience any symptoms because their spleen is able to remove the infected cells from the blood. But when the body's immune system is compromised by another condition such as Lyme disease, the spleen can become overworked and the Babesia parasite takes hold. If that happens, the consequences can be dire.